Hi everybody, welcome. My name's Matt. It's great to be here to bring you this video to discuss the new release for CXWorks, CXWorks number 14. And what a great release it is. We've got some really cool innovations in the workout. We've got some great movements. We've set to great music. And it's just going to help you and your class build enormous core strength onwards and upwards as we prepare for release 15, which is coming at you at Phylex in April. So that's really exciting down in Melbourne. So we look forward to that. But for now, let's discuss release 14. We're bringing you this because there's no workshops this round, so we wanted to give you a little bit of education. And what I want to do on this video is just discuss the release track by track, tie in the info about some of the movements that are coming up that you're going to see, some of the things that might help you as you're learning it and initially teaching the release back at your clubs. But also revisit the qualification of options, which is something that we talk about at module training, which I'm sure you'll remember. And the qualification of options basically entails providing our classes, our members, with information specifically as to why they should take an option. It's never if it's too much, if it's too intensive, if it's too hard, because it kind of gives people a way out. What we aim to do is let people know where the work is supposed to be felt, where it shouldn't be felt, and if they're feeling it in this place where they shouldn't, then they need to take this option. And once they've rested and recovered in that option, they try to resume the full option as soon as they can. And that way, maybe they'll get back to the high option before the end of the movement sequence and push themselves a little bit harder than they thought they could or would. So in track one, the two standout features from a choreography perspective is the quick, slow rhythm. Now your first movement in the track one is a double leg lift, and there's lots of repetitions of that. So you've got plenty of time to coach great lower back alignment, great 90 degree leg alignment as well. So people get effective short lever loading in the lower portion of their abdominals. It really works well at class level if you pre-cue front leg, quick, slow, because the double leg lift moves into the single leg lift on that quick, slow rhythm. But you've got plenty of time to pre-cue it whilst you're doing the double leg lifts. And there's quite a big musical landmark that you'll notice in the last two reps of the double leg lift, so check that out. That comes back quite quickly. That rhythm and the leg lift comes back quite quickly later on in the track one, but it's a cross crawl. So again, you've got plenty of repetitions of the lift, reach, center and drop crunch sequence. There's enough repetitions of that to verbally pre-cue. Guys, we've got that leg rhythm coming back, but this time we bring the shoulder to the opposite knee. It's a cross crawl. So you can set it up like that, and that will just allow for really cool, smooth transitions, and your class will be able to follow the choreography well and get the workout that they came for, get the warm-up for the workout that they came for. The other different aspect about this track one, and we don't go here very often, is we are actually going long levered in this warm-up. Because we're going long levered, we need to coach and role model no lower than 45 degrees as the legs extend away. Track two, we can offer the option of going lower, but we don't want people to blow out in track one. So definitely moving and extending your alternating single leg extensions no lower than 45 degrees. So please check that out and please practice that as you're preparing to launch the release. Moving into track two, we start in a hover position and we've got plenty of time to set that up. And we want to make sure that people, they're going to start in a level one hover with the knees down. And we want to make sure that the butt is level with the shoulders, because the next movement that comes along in the choreography is a knee lift and drop, a double leg knee lift and drop. So if you remember Vogue, it's like the knee drop in hover. Basically, you're in a level one hover, you extend both legs, you're in level two, you drop back down to level one, you go back to level two. Now, from your butt to your head, nothing moves. It's only the knee joint that extends. So just make sure that as you are opening and closing at the knee and the knees touch lightly down, that your butt isn't changing height. So it's going to be a really cool way to set people up in great technique in the hover, help them to understand that regardless of whether they're on the knees or on the toes, the butt to the head alignment, i.e. that long flat back, which is our compulsory cue, that long straight flat back, that position doesn't change throughout the move. Once you've pre-fatigued the abdominals with that great exercise there, you're going to flip over, you're going to get into an extended leg position. So we've got to coach lower back close to the floor, that's crucial. Starting with the legs at 45 degrees, if people can't keep their lower back stable, they definitely need to bring their legs a little bit higher. And then we layer in the speed leg drop, which is a great training stimulus. You know, that real rapid descending of the leg, the break at the bottom, forcing the abdominals to stop that really long lever as it plummets towards the ground. When you've got the option later of starting the speed leg drop with your legs on 45 degrees. And that's going to mean that your abdominals just don't get an opportunity to switch off. So that really ramps up the intensity. If that's too much to have the legs at 45 degrees and go that speed leg drop, it's totally cool to bring the legs to a vertical position, which is where you would have moved to earlier. Okay, so the choreography is intelligent, it builds. Make sure that the crux of it all is that you've got to keep the lower back stable. And if you can't, then you're going to have to keep the legs higher. If your back is stable, go for gold. Push yourself and make sure that, you know, the core is consistently loaded with no stress in the lower back. So it's a nice track. It finishes off with a static hover. Try and really motivate people to get up into that full hover for as long as they can, because if it's hitting the lower back, they must drop back down to the knees in that hover position. And for the double leg lift and drop in the hover, the option, you know, should people not be able to keep their body stable, or if the butt sags and the lower back pays the price, then they need to work a single leg variation. But this is all really well coached on the DVD, and you'll see. But the qualification of option is, if you're feeling this in your lower back, in the hover, please take the knee down, a single leg variation. And if you can't keep your lower back close to the floor in the speed leg drop and the leg extending movements, then take the legs higher to the ceiling. Moving into track three, what would be a great thing for you to start doing right now in your classes to prepare your classes and set them up for success is to start teaching the bonus track three from release 13, because it's got the L press in it, and the L press is back in 14 within the release. So we want people to get comfortable with this move. And as you're preparing to launch, doing the bonus track three from 13 will help you in your class to build the motor skills and the fitness that you need for this particular movement. The key thing to coach when you're doing it is that the back leg arm is the one that goes up, and that you kind of load, so the tubing is going to come down. I've got the tubing here. The tubing is going to come down the inside part of your elbow. Now you're in this kind of rack position here, your thumb is towards your front shoulder, the other arm is long and down by your thigh, and then you push, and you need to push straight up. And then you return to that rack position. So thumb towards front shoulder, little finger faces the front. You're gonna see some funny things happening here, so aim to set that up really clearly. The option, if people burn out in this vertical arm, is just to lose it and stay with the side arm. Okay, so this one's quite achievable. This one is the challenge. Dan coaches and motivates really well on the DVD, so you'll see that. But the option is lose that lifted arm for a few reps, recharge, and then get back in if you can. Once you get to the squat press combo, because we've got the option to use the tube or the option to use the plate, neither of which is easy. The tubing just loads your back, and when you stretch it as much as Dan does on the DVD, it's really going to load your back, and the plate loads your shoulders. So the tubing isn't an easy option, it's just a different option to choose from, depending on where you want to feel the load, which area of your body feels strongest maybe. So that's your track three. We've also got the power skater. And the power skater is a really, really cool move for chiseling through the obliques. And the option is always to drop to one handle. And you drop to one handle if you're just losing form or losing great posture. The key to focus on is that your hips must stay square. And to achieve that, you push the butt back, bringing the torso forward with a long spine. Handles stay anchored to the center of the chest, and your front elbow will end up pointing on a downward diagonal. So you step, butts back, chest forward, rotate. Try not to be upright in this position, because that's going to force too much stress through the hip, and ultimately the hips will twist potentially. But getting the butt back will load strongly into this moving leg and enable you to get onto a downward diagonal with that front elbow. So have a little look at that. If the resistance is too great, then by all means go to one handle and try to make sure that it's always the outside handle that they stay with, because then it will grip around their shoe better. So there's your track three and the options, and so why you might take them. the track four is my favorite. So the music is so cool. And you're gonna burn out your butt a lot, which is great because it's the hip strengthening track. So, excuse me, the alignment is key. You gotta make sure that people tip forward so their nose is forward of their toes, not over their toes, forward of their toes. The standing leg is bent. This will engage the glute and will challenge the glute via stability demands. The moving leg is dead straight and it moves from the glute. So that's going to give you a real butt burner. Round one, 32 reps on that side. You kind of think, oh yeah, that's not too bad. Then you have to stand on that leg that you've just moved and that becomes the stabilizing leg. And it's then that you realize, yeah, it's a little bit tired. When you go into the next movement, that back, back, forward, forward, but wide, wide, in, that's when you really start to feel it. When you get to round two later on in the choreography, there's another challenge. Your challenge when you get to the end is as you extend your arms forward, you need to keep your body square. So it's cool to keep the hands on the hips with the tube. And a little tip there would be to anchor the thumbs over the sort of back of your pelvis. Isn't it just enables you to switch off your posture? And when you're in the movement here, the option most advanced is to extend the arms. So you've got to make sure that your class doesn't start to open out, because if they open out, they're not going to get the same glute load as they will if they stay square. Oh. It's tough, you wait till you do that one. But luckily the music's really, really cool, so that always helps us through the workout. When you get into the track five, you've got that quick, quick, slow rhythm coming back. Or let's just backtrack for a second. Options for track four, it's always cool to do the whole track without the tube, that's always okay. And they can tap the back foot down if they need to balance, but there's never any weight in that back foot. So when you're doing those rear leg extensions, what you don't want to happen is for people to spring out of it. Keep the standing leg static and strong. Keep the moving leg long and powerful. Okay? So tap the back foot for balance. No tube is cool. If no tube gives you greater precision, awesome. Track five, you welcome back the quick, quick, slow cross crawl rhythm. And that becomes, because you're going long levered now in the track five, the option, of course, if you're rocking through the pelvis or if you're pulling on your head or losing form, is to stay with the warm-up version of a toe tap, quick, quick, slow, cross crawl. But long leg becomes a real heart rate lifter. So it's great. It's a really nice feel in this track and hopefully will leave you and your members breathless just a little bit as you venture into round one and round two. You've got the side hover, which is executed from the knee. So elbow directly under shoulder, knee down, side hover. When you lift your top leg, lift it long with the horizon, point the toe, squeeze the quad and pull the kneecap up, just like Dan coaches on the DVD. That will give you great precision and length through your lifted leg, and then you tap it down really, really quickly. And your body is in stealth mode, so your body doesn't move. It's just that leg that's adding load, and it's up to you to hold this great side hover position. So look forward to that. When you add on the side crunch from the side hover, remember that as you reach away, let's show you. As you reach away, you need to achieve precision. So that arm reaches away long with the palm facing down, toes pointed, leg away, boom. Knee comes towards elbow, elbow toward knee, and your body doesn't change length. So you're just using the arm and the leg to challenge with load. It's up to you to maintain a fantastic side hover position as the arm and leg move. And because obviously we want to lengthen our levers, so palm down, everything, get really great length through the arm, reaching away through the fingertips, point the toes away so your arm and leg are as long as they can be, and they're stretching away from your core. I guess if you know if your class was failing with that, or if their form was lost and they were really, really struggling, then they could just hold the side hover, static side hover for a little bit, rest a few reps. There's only about 12 to 16 repetitions anyway, so it's not too bad. I think it's actually 14 reps. I'm being musically driven and not counting the repetitions there, but you'll see. You've got to transition out of it. It is 14 reps. You've got to transition out of it because you need to get set up into the cross crawl rhythm, but you'll see that when you learn the choreography. So that's that for the track five. When you get into the track six, we've got seated rows. And maybe in the past there was some feedback that came back with the traditional position of treating the handles like stirrups. People were struggling to get the right amount of resistance. Trust me, with this new variation, they're going to have more than enough resistance because this is how we set it up. You put both handles in one hand, you pinch the tubing, wrapping it around the center of your feet. Both handles in one hand, hand into the other side of the tubing, in the loop of the tubing, proud posture, knees slightly bent, leaning back to activate into the core. You then row and you pinch in between your shoulder blades and then flare the arms out wide as they return back to the long position. So it's like you pull in a straight line and then flare outwards and around in a semicircle path. Okay, so it's going to give you really, really great work into the posterior chain. If you're teaching solo, then it's going to be quite important for you at some point to coach the option of just a single tube. Because that double tube, particularly if you're using the black ones, you don't have very much range. You can't achieve very much range because there's so much resistance on that when the tube is bent over double like that. So just play with it and see which one works best with you. Maybe you might set up with the tubing doubled to get everybody to have a go. And then you stop, miss a couple of reps, reset, get into the role model of the single tube, and then get back into the double tube before the end of the movement sequence. You're there for quite a long time, so there's plenty of time to teach it. And then, of course, once you roll over and you get into the back extensions, then you've just got to coach squeeze your butt. And you'll see some arm movements within the back extension sequence that will further challenge the postural muscles of the back and really fire up that posterior chain. So from an option perspective, double up the tube or use the tube singly, wrapping it around the feet. And that's pretty much it. Dan coaches if it gets a little bit too much pressure, or if, you know, if you can't get range, then bend the knees more. But if you want to, you can extend the legs away, and that's cool. Probably what you'll find is that the tubing variations, there'll be a lot of people, especially if they're on a double tube, that will be bending their legs up. So have a little look out to your class and see that one happening. And that's pretty much it in a nutshell for release 14. As I said, it's great. The music is fantastic, and that's going to really help you to achieve great things because we know how much the music drives us within this workout. Look at your class and teach to what you see. Know that there are going to be people there that need the lower options to cater for where their fitness is at right now, or to cater for any pre-existing injuries that they might have. So we've got to coach to the lower end of intensity. But there are also going to be people there that really want to smash this workout. So aim to be a role model for them too, and coach the high-end options as well. So a way that you can do this is that whenever you coach a low, in the next breath, say, but what about this one if you want more? So that way, you know, within a couple of reps, people know which way they should go. This way, for a safety concern or a safety issue, if the work is going somewhere where it shouldn't. But if you're stable, then take yourself up here and really push this workout hard. We're only there for half an hour after all, hey. So I hope that you enjoyed the workout. I hope that this video was helpful to you, and look forward to seeing you at Phylex for release 15, which is amazing too. And that's April 4th to 6th. So for now, thanks ever so much, everybody. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you.